Full moons happen about every 29 and a half days, as a moon reaches the side of the Earth directly opposite the Sun. At this point in its cycle, the Earth, Moon, and Sun are aligned in a straight line, causing the Moon's surface to be fully illuminated as seen from Earth. This alignment is what we know as a full moon. The moon doesn't produce its own light. The silvery glow we see is reflected sunlight from the moon's surface. This is why we see different phases of the moon as it orbits the Earth. As light cannot pass through the moon, one half of it is constantly exposed to the sun, while the other remains in darkness. This means that while it is day on one part of the moon, it is night on the other. From the Earth, we are only able to observe one phase of the moon. And during this phase, the side of the moon that we can see is fully illuminated by the sun. Hence the name full moon, as the entire portion of the moon illuminated by the sun is observable from Earth. However, from a technical standpoint, this could be the true half moon. The full moon, with its magnificent shine, is one of the most stunning views in the night sky. For countless generations, it has kindled the imaginations of poets and artists, and its allure persists to this day. The full moon is visible throughout the night, rising around 6 p.m. and setting around 6 a.m. The full moon phase also has one of the strongest effects on Earth's tides, caused by the gravitational attraction of the Sun and Moon. As a result, tides experience their maximum range, reaching both their highest and lowest points. These are called spring tides, during which the oceans exhibit their greatest swell. The increased nighttime illumination during a full moon stimulates greater fish activity, improving their ability to see and find food. This may allow fish to reach new feeding grounds that would normally be out of their reach. It is widely believed that under a full moon, plant foliage growth is more pronounced than root development. The upward movement of plant sap is intensified under a full moon, stimulating the growth of stems, branches, and leaves. A lunar eclipse happens when the Earth gets between the Sun and the Moon, and the Earth's shadow makes the Moon dark. For a lunar eclipse to occur, the three celestial bodies, the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun, must be perfectly aligned. In this position, the Earth blocks the Sun's light, preventing it from reaching the Moon. Therefore, the full moon is completely obscured during the night, as the Earth's shadow covers it. The moon turns a reddish color during a total eclipse due to the scattering of light refracted by the Earth's atmosphere. the Moon travels around our planet in an elliptical orbit. Each month, the Moon goes through its closest point to Earth, called perigee, and its farthest point, called apogee. A full moon that occurs at perigee is known as a supermoon. During this event, because the full moon is slightly closer to Earth, it appears larger and brighter than usual. On average, supermoons happen 3 to 4 times a year. Want to know when the next supermoons and lunar eclipses are? This link has all the info you need, so you don't miss out on these incredible events. If you find this video helpful, share it with a friend and hit the subscribe button to see more great content. Thank you.